How can Sony make Spider-Man a big success without having to rely on the MCU? This is a question we've been asked on a channel a bunch, so I'm gonna go over this and how I think personally that they could have two different Spider-Men, or even one, played by Tom Holland, shared by two properties, but how to make everything around him even better and more important. So let's get into that. And as always, thank you guys for watching. If you don't mind, like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell. So Spider-Man is not just Peter Parker. There are so many different Spider-Men out there, so I think Sony personally has to utilize this. Now, when I say how to make Spider-Man a success first and foremost, I don't mean that he wasn't successful before the MCU. The Raimi trilogy had its fans, TASM has its fans, but the era of a standalone Spider-Man that exists by himself just doesn't work anymore. Comic book films don't work like that anymore because the audiences have been conditioned to understand shared universes and all these interconnected pieces. So when you look at it that way, they have to utilize this. And when you look at Sony and what they're developing, I think you start to see the picture that's being painted in front of you. Madame Web will naturally lead to some sort of giant Spider-Man multiverse team-up thing that they're gonna try to do. At the same time, you have to diversify the portfolio of Spider-Man. So yes, you can have Peter Parker, that's great, he's recognizable, but Miles Morales, he makes money, he's really popular, he can completely service a different crowd, so you're gonna bring that in. We know that's happening, Tom Holland said as much. So then you look at some other things that you have in development that you can kind of gold mine or data mine, if you will, for Spider-Man, and you look at the likes of Ghost Spider, Spider-Gwen. Again, that's a female Spider-Man, so bring that in. And again, it's Gwen Stacy, so she's recognizable. Then you look at somebody else, like Silk, for example. There's no way, and I don't understand why, Sony keeps ignoring this character. You literally hit every check mark on what every Hollywood studio wants today. Superhero, female, and a demographic that's not being represented in Hollywood in every fashion. An Asian. Like, it's right there, right? And I think that's a go-to. Again, that's a big one. At the same time, I've talked about it before, 2099. That's a unique aesthetic. That's something that people will literally flock to. Now, you don't need to give these movies the biggest budgets. You can do these on the cheap because that's how you have to do it, because you want to make sure you're recouping more money down the road. But $100 million budget for something like, let's say, Silk, or something like Spider-Man Noir in a live action, right? You can see how that would work, and you can see that just because Spider-Man, it will bring in a certain crowd, and you can make your money back by the second weekend. And certainly, if you cast actors that represent a certain ethnicity and a certain cultural shift that's happening in Hollywood, you then push it to that market more, and you're gonna recoup more there. This is just like evidenced by everything you look at. This is why Marvel Studios is making Shang-Chi. This is really important. And if you just look at history, Wonder Woman, big success. Captain Marvel, big success. Black Panther, big success. You have to target that specific crowd that you're going after. Spider-Man, more so than any other Marvel character, literally lends himself to this giant universe. And if you look at how much he sells, it's right there. People want more of him. So for Sony to be able to really go out there and find one thing that works that nobody else has, it's versions of Spider-Man that you can sell to every single person out there. And why not invent some of your own? I mean, instead of that, let's just data mine a little more, right? Let's go Spider. Let's go with the punk rocker, right? Or let's go with some sort of more violent version. Or let's do the Clone Saga. Or let's just make a straight up Ben Reilly movie, right? Like, there's a lot here. So go after it. Do not just stick to what's worked before, because people are getting sick of that. That's why certain franchises are coming out and you're expecting them to be a success, and people are going, I've seen this before, I don't want this. Right? You have to innovate and push forward. So do that with the Spider-Man property. It's literally made for mining.